What's up, fire signs? I'm Laurel, and welcome to Laurel's Moon and This Bitch. Join me as I read you your motherfucking lives, baby. Thank you to everyone who has liked, shared, commented, subscribed to my channel. You already know I appreciate each and every single one of you motherfuckers. Yes, I do, baby. And if you need to get a personal reading from me, make sure that you hit that description box down below. Check out my website, laurelsmoon.com, for any other magical purposes and deviation workings and things of that nature. So, spirit, you are welcome into this reading. You must sage the cards for all of my fire gods, Leo, Sagittarius, Aries. Let's see what's going down for the motherfucking weekend. I'm going to start out with my Leos. We're going to get the overall energies, and then we're going to see what's happening with my ones that are in love and the ones that are single. So let's see what's popping in this motherfucker. Also, make sure you hit that like button while you are here. Uh-oh, bounce it, Leo booty rising. Ow. Come have a seat. Come to mama. Come to mama. Anyway, Leos, let's see what's going down. All right, we got mural, be your own first priority. So y'all know what that means. This motherfucker gonna shoot me off anyway, honey. And he getting his priorities in order. So for some of you Leos, there could be some prioritizing you might be doing for the weekend. Ow. Let's see what's going down. I'm going to get my romance angels in this motherfucker. So, Leos, let's see what's going down. I'm seeing a lot of you guys are doing some home decorations, or all together you just want to do something artistic. You got worth waiting for. Divine timing is at work in your love life. So, to my Leos, and it's also saying you deserve love. You're lovable. Whenever I get this card, somebody might be feeling lonely or something. It's also saying calling in your soulmates. Finance is a career at the bottom of the deck. So let's get right into this motherfucking shit. Some of you guys are worried about a relationship or worried about the future. All right, very first card out for those of you all that are in love. You have the Queen of Cups, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, also Leo, Sagittarius, Aries that is coming in your direction. Okay, there could be somebody wanting to display some sort of love, but there's also somebody wanting to rush a situation. Now, you do have the Chariot energy, and I feel like somebody's making a final decision, Leos. I feel like some of you guys might be dealing with very cold energy, or this person is definitely being shown some light with the Judgment and the Queen of Swords here. World, Two of Cups, and Six of Wands. So there is something successful coming up for those of you all that are in a relationship. Might be that there could be some traveling or some sort of trip, or there could be some things that are happening overseas with this world energy here. But something's getting ready to open up with a relationship. Two of Cups. Five of Pentacles in reverse. So somebody's getting ready to open up. Like I told y'all in y'all video for the month of October, somebody's having some hard times with their communication, but they're able to open themselves to something a little bit different is what I'm seeing this weekend. Okay. Ow. Let's see about my single Leos. Definitely some sort of romance happening for those of you all that are in love. Single Leos. Five of Wands and King of Swords. Wow, very sharp energy. Could be that somebody is cutting something off. Or there's definitely somebody who's making a decision for some of my single Leos. This could be you getting to the action as well, too. You have the Queen of Wands at the bottom of the deck. So somebody's wanting to make some moves here. Okay, but for a lot of you guys, there could be some truths that might come out between you and your partner. So be careful with that shit. Here we go. Sagittarius for the weekend. Sagittarius for the weekend. Give it to me. What do they need to know about? What's the advice? We have potion. Remember to practice self-love. And also saying to release your guilt as well, too. So you could be needing to release some truths or just altogether how you feel about a situation. But definitely time for self-exploration. Let's see what the romance angels have to say for those that are in love. And then we'll see about my single Sagittarius. Here we go. You have love yourself first. Very first card coming out. And heart-to-heart conversation. So I do see some of you guys are taking things in retrospect, and there might be a real conversation that needs to be had. Or this could be you just loving yourself first and then being able to be honest and direct. But it's saying very soon you're going to make a decision. So let's see what's up. Sagittarius. For the weekend. In love. All right, Ten of Swords here. So there could be some endings, okay? But with the Ten of Swords, somebody's kind of pissed off, or there's somebody who's angry, or there is some healing that's taking place, okay, with this Ten of Swords. Somebody might be in the dark, or there could be some things that need to happen that need to be shown in the light. Now, I do see partnerships that could be working together with this Two of Wands, okay? I'm also getting Six of Wands and Magician. So you could be dealing with, I'm seeing like three different energies here for some of you Sagittarius. This could be Aries, Gemini, Virgo. You also have Taurus and energy as well, and Scorpio that I'm picking up on. For those of you all that are in love, I feel somebody is not really ready to manifest quite on the level that you're on, but I do see somebody's willing to work on the partnership. Okay, but it's time to have that conversation about what you're doing, what y'all spending y'all money on, shit like that. All right, here we go. Single Sagittarius. Over the weekend, you have the Five of Cups in reverse, Two of Swords here. So somebody's made a decision. They are no longer crying over spilled milk, honey. You also have the Three of Cups. So there could be some parties or some sort of entertainment that might be coming about very soon with the star energy here. So for a lot of you Sagittarius, I'm seeing a lot of tranquil energy that's coming towards you. But you also need to heal yourself and just take some time for yourself. For all of you Sagittarius all together is what I'm picking up. Could be dealing with an Aquarian though. All right, also Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. So let's see what's popping with my Aries for the weekend. Give me the advice, what they need to know about overall for my Aries. We have throne. Your potential is endless. Okay, so some of you guys are sitting on your throne. You might be thinking about what you're sitting on. Okay, and what's yours? When I think of a throne, what's mine? Okay, fuck a crown. But definitely thinking or sitting on some sort of idea or being very flexible. This could be in your imagination or just altogether your style. Here we go, romance angels for my Aries for the weekend. We have stay optimistic about your love life. Positive thinking and faith will bring your ass some romance and free yourself. Okay, it's time to take back control of your life. And this could be the one. Interesting. You also have a reconciliation coming up over the weekend for some of you Aries, but I feel like this is going to set the tone of how your love languages are mix and mashing together. Some of you all need to free yourself from a little dusty though. Straight like that. Let's see what's popping for those that are in motherfucking love. For my Eddies, it's saying to stay optimistic. You never know about this motherfucker. Okay, or you've already met this romantic partner that you've been seeking or looking for or searching for, whatever the case may be. But it's saying to love yourself first. I did just see the Ice Queen. Queen of Swords. So some of you guys might be very stern, or they're just all together as a stone cold Steve Austin type of energy. Alright. Here we go. Hermits. Star. Eight of Cups. Eight of Wands. So I'm seeing a lot of eights. Somebody's definitely needing to communicate, or there is some communication that's getting ready to come up between your partnership. Okay, or there's a somebody's going to be honest and direct, but it might hurt a little bit of feelings with some truth and honesty. But I do see with the Two of Cups. There is some love here in your relationship now. There might be something that's boosted because you have the Ace of Swords and also the Ten of Cups and the Two of Cups. So somebody is definitely getting ready to have some information brought to them or some truth that's coming together in a relationship for sure. Now this could be some long-term, talking about some long-term type of things with the Ten of Pentacles, Four of Wands here, all right? Now, for some of you singles, there could be some spying that's going on. Princess of Swords and also Temperance energy. This could be with a Sagittarius. So I do feel like somebody wants to try to make things right or trying to blend things, but there's somebody who's watching a situation, you know, very precisely. Five of Swords here. Somebody might be hurt, but at the same time, you might be ready to start some new shit over with this fool or ready to just do and be down for whatever. But just be careful. For some of you singles, you got somebody who's watching your situation. They kind of stuck in the past, and it might be somebody who's very toxic with this double energy here popping up. Just be careful with that, all right? But I see a lot of peace that's coming towards some of you guys. So, my loves, I love you all so much. I'm going to get on out of here. If you need to get a personal reading from me, make sure that you hit that description box down below. Check out my website, therellsmoon.com. Also, make sure you check the description box down below for my four questions for $25. And I'll see you guys in the next motherfucking video. Have a wonderful weekend.